Good evening and welcome to the 2012 Optimist Club Independence Day Parade. My name is Linda Marcoux.
And my name is Don Barranco.
And we're your hosts this evening. We hope you have a wonderful time. It's one of the hottest days of the year, Don.
This is about my 25th or 26th parade, and I can't remember a hotter one.
Oh.
I've done everything from make cotton candy to be a parade marshal. This is my first opportunity to sit down with you, Linda, and you're a trained professional.
Yes,
I hope I don't make too many mistakes.
No, it's great to have you, Don.
Thank you.
And this is our 30th, the Optimist 30th year having our parade. We'd like to welcome you again, and let's get going. We are going to have, this is our popcorn wagon that we have on the corner of Appleton and Pilgrim, and we hope you have visited it. The proceeds go to the scholarships that the Optimist Club gives for the high school students.
The popcorn wagon is open every evening from 6:30 to 9:30 p.m., weather permitting, and it's run by the volunteers of the Optimist Club. Both Linda and I are Optimist Club members, and as Linda said, we've been running this parade for many, many years. Each year it seems to get a little bigger.
It does.
Although this year, Linda, I think it's a late arriving crowd because of the heat.
I think so, too. Hello.
The Optimist credo is working for the children of Menomonee Falls. I like the slogan we put on the side of our wagon, which is popping for kids.
I think that's great.
I'm guessing there's going to be 75 volunteers here or more from the Optimist Club today.
Right. We have over 190 members of our club.
Right now, we may believe we may be the largest Optimist Club in the United States. We definitely are the largest in the state of Wisconsin.
You will see Jer Bear, and he's the bubble clown. He came through a little bit earlier. There he is.
And the jugglers.
Oh, the bubbles.
That's the Heads Up Juggling Review. And they're here to entertain the crowd. They've been up and down the parade route for the last half hour.
Right. It's a father and son team. They juggled together and started a group, and they say jugglers find one another. We do see the flag coming up here.
Just a moment to introduce Harry Stetzel and his crew, although they will be behind the scenes tonight. Harry's crew has been filming this parade for a number of years, and they do a wonderful job. Looks like our cameramen this year are Gordon Kirchhoff, Joe Crowley, and Ike Weens.
They do a wonderful job.
And I hope I got those names right.
They're our backup crew. They are our people.
And everybody needs people.
Yes. And this looks to be the Milwaukee Metropolitan Non-Commissioned Officer Council.
This group is active, retired, reserves, and former armed forces members from the four county area.
They've been around for 52 years this year. They were founded in 1960, and it's the only unit from Wisconsin to participate in the 1993 inaugural parade in Washington, D.C.
They'll be at German Fest. They'll be at the opening ceremony and the parade, and Purple Heart Day at the Milwaukee War Memorial, along with other events that have to do with the Veterans Day parade and the Veterans Day banquet.
Here's some of our crowd relaxing, having fun.
I'm guessing quite a bit of sunscreen was used today.
I think so. The sun is going down now, so it should be more comfortable.
police chief in that vehicle?
Yes.
And I'm an embarrassed Optimist Club member because I cannot remember her name. Again, this is the Milwaukee Metropolitan Non-Commissioned Officers Council.
And a big round of applause as our American flag passes. And Pearl Harbor Survivors Association. We do have Mildred Beltman. And I'd like to congratulate her on her 90th birthday today.
Mildred trained in 1943. Oh, it's not on there.
We were a little bit premature because we wanted to really give her a round of applause here on her 90th birthday. You can see the Optimist Club banner carried by the Menomonee Falls Junior Indians Baseball Club, formerly known as Falls Falcons.
This group has been organized for the past 10 years, and they annually send a couple of teams to Cooperstown. They offer young men the opportunity to participate in advanced baseball competition that goes above and beyond what they would find in Little League.
We have some Optimist people in their golf carts. They drive up and down the street selling cotton candy and popcorn. This is the American Legion Band, post number 91.
They were a community band that was originally sponsored by the Carnation Company, and they were affiliated in 1924, and that's when they took their present name. Thank you.
Johns. They've been in our parade every year for 30 years, and they always lead off our bands for our parade.
They are specializing, of course, in military service marches. And if you can't get into the Independence Day spirit with that, you can't get into the spirit.
Here is Mildred. She is 90 years old. Mildred Beltman. In 1943, she trained at Indiana State University in Bloomington, stationed at the 9th Naval District in Chicago. She became engaged, and her fiancé had to go in the Battle of the Bulge, was captured as a POW for 2.5 years, but they were married on July 22, 1945.
That's several years before either one of us were born.
I think so.
And here's the Post 382 vets from Wisconsin.
We have the American Milwaukee Women's and American Legion, U.S. Jane Delano, Post 448. It's an all-women's post, and it was formed over 60 years ago. When the women left the military, they needed a place where other women veterans could get together.
They are recognized at Badger Girls State every year for their coloring and their essay contest. They also are in the Memorial Day Parade, and they stand down by helping homeless veterans. And, of course, they also work with Badger Boys State.
We have the United Proud Patriots, Menomonee Falls. They were formed in Menomonee Falls after Desert Storm in 1990. They have a building on Main Street. And they've been 22 years together. Menomonee Falls Fire Department is next. The village board meeting on May 30th, 1894, decided to organize a volunteer fire department. Now it's staffed by a combination of volunteer, part-time, and full-time personnel. They provide emergency medical, rescue, hazardous material, public education, and fire prevention.
One of the most popular events that they hold, and one of the most educational events they hold each year, is the Milwaukee Safety Fair. This year it will be held on September the 8th at Menomonee Falls High School.
Upcoming is our president, Kathy Sharkey, the Optimist Club president for this year, in a Beetle.
Looks like an original one, Linda.
And
it is.
And it is Ed Schlumpf, one of our members who's driving that car.
Followed by John Seymour, affectionately known by many of his friends as Jack. He's our parade marshal this year. John has been in this parade, or has helped on this parade for many years, and he's just an outstanding member of the Menomonee Falls community. I believe he was once a community person of the year, wasn't he?
He was, yes.
Always has a smile on his face.
Always. And here we have the Stilt Walkers.
And the Hoofbeats Express are heading down this way.
They carry the Distinguished Young Women. It's a scholarship program that we have in Menomonee Falls, and the Optimist Club does sponsor that.
It is one of the many things that the Optimist Club does sponsor, and we'll have an opportunity to talk about some of them. This event used to be known as the Junior Miss Program, and it's a scholarship program, and the name was changed several years ago.
It's been going for 46 years. I believe the first carriage has our winner, Eilish Sarah Zimbilki.
Yes. Glad you did that one.
I practiced. She will be going to, I believe, Mobile, Alabama for a competition down there later this year. And the second carriage has Michelle Pohl, Rebecca Makowski, Meredith Frey, Megan Perinvik, Rebecca Gerald Limick, Rachel Griffin Camp, Sally Vin May, and Lauren Sinicki.
Here comes one of our favorite groups. That's the West Dallas Lancer Band. This group is from, of course, West Dallas, and it's part of the West Dallas, West Milwaukee School District. It's been around for 31 years. They received first place awards in Waukegan, Sussex, and four Washington parades over the years.
Don, they're going to be in three parades tomorrow.
Those will be some tired kids by
Whoa,
tomorrow night.
Oh, hot. We have the Wells Fargo Stagecoach, and in 1909, with great optimism, Wells Fargo arrived aboard Chicago, Milwaukee, and St. Paul Railroad, and agent M.A. Ashley optimistically threw open his office doors. Today, the Wells Fargo Stagecoach rolls through Menomonee Falls in our Optimist Club Parade. Thanks for Wells Fargo's appearance. Go to Patricia Holtz of Wells Fargo. This coach was from Davenport, Iowa.
Our local Menomonee Falls retail branch sponsored this event. Riding in this wagon were Tony Alvarez, Brooke Nowaba, Jenny Griepentrog, Serenity Medina, and Nathan Holtz.
And we have the Vietnam veterans here, the War Dogs. This is the War Dogs unit that we usually have, but it was too hot for the dogs to accompany them.
Those are some good owners.
Yes, they are good to their dogs. Do I hear a band?
I do hear a band.
Here comes the UW Marching Band. It's a 30-member band this year.
And, of course, they're playing the Bud Song.
They're going to be performing for the crowd at the fireworks right after the parade in the high school field.
Nothing more fun than this band.
That was fun.
I've been a band follower since, a long time.
We do have a special guest who just arrived. We have, following the band, we have
Governor Scott Walker.
Welcome, Governor Walker.
Welcome, Governor Walker.
He's coming over to visit us.
Good luck to you and your walk. I'm guessing he's going to be in a few parades.
I would imagine. His wife accompanied him.
Yes, and I should know her name because both Scott and his wife were on TV a lot.
Right. Next, we have the Children's Community Center, which was established in 1975.
I've been fortunate to... I'm sorry, Linda, go ahead.
Oh, well, they share environment with the Birth to Three Early Intervention Program. Yes?
Yes, they do. And go ahead, because I lost my script.
Okay. They provide a safe, secure environment for infants as young as 1 month and continuing programs for children up to 12 years of age.
I've been fortunate in many different ways, and I think Linda has too, to have children and grandchildren use the services of Children's Community Center. And right now, my one of my daughters-in-law is a teacher there. It's a wonderful organization.
It is. Their express purpose of providing quality early education and child care to young children, thereby helping them develop positive attitudes about themselves and others, which will enable them to function responsibly and happily in our society. Boy, that's what you hope for, don't you?
You really do.
We really have a great crowd here at our parade, and you're seeing some of the participants.
And as I said, it was a late arriving crowd. Here we've got the Janesville Fife and Drum Corps out of Janesville. It was founded in 1975 by Robert Williams. He assembled the group through the Janesville Public Schools to prepare them for the nation's bicentennial. And in 2012, it's going to be their 37th season.
There's a future for that little one. Having a ball.
The type of music that they specialize in is related to the Revolutionary War, French Indian War, and original music is performed by the core members.
And here we have Tommy Thompson for Senator.
Hard for me to think of him not as Governor Thompson.
I know.
I don't actually see Tommy out there. Have you seen him
yet,
Linda?
Not yet. He's here. He's probably shaking hands somewhere.
That would be my guess.
There he is on the other side of the street.
Oh, yes. In the blue shirt.
Right. He was elected to Congress in 19... No, he wasn't. Not yet.
No.
He's hoping to be. Okay, and this is the Republican Party of Waukesha County. And we have the Wisconsin chapter of the Model A Ford Club of America, and right behind him,
Kalowitz for County Clerk. And Kathy Kalowitz is out there throwing candy with the rest of them.
You see Alberta, Senator Alberta Darling, and she is Senator for the 8th Senate District, which is comprised of Menomonee Falls, Butler, Richfield, Germantown, Mequon, and Milwaukee's North Shore. She was elected to the State Senate in 1992 and reelected ever since.
Including a recall election last year.
Yes. She's the main author of several monumental pieces of legislation, including sexual predator law.
Here's Dan Brackus.
Dan Brackus,
our county, Waukesha County Executive.
He was elected in 2005 and re-elected in 2007. Hi, Dan. And he is driven by Jerry Behrens.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Dan Canodolo, our one of our local state reps, is coming along. Followed by Jeff Fitzgerald's run for the U.S. Senate. Jeff is one of the several candidates that we have on the Republican side of the ledger running in this upcoming November.
Dan Knodel is also an optimist.
He is an optimist. Oh, there's a couple more optimists. Those two we know.
It's our Bucket Brigade.
It's the Bucket Brigade. They have been. Yes.
How you doing?
Oh, isn't she sweet? Red, white, and blue.
Look at that little tutu.
Yeah.
Am I allowed to say that on camera?
I think so.
Okay. Oh, my goodness. I just love to watch the little ones at these parades.
Yes.
And here's another set of them.
They're all set for the candy, I think.
As Linda and I have talked about, the Menomonee Falls Optimist Club supports a number of different events. And one of them is the post-pom.
And here we have the...
We have Shark the Fire Truck. The Stark Fire Truck.
Upcoming, just coming into view, we have the Daily Debutantes Baton and Drum Corps. And Jessica Longley of Menomonee Falls is a senior assistant corps captain. She's a graduate of Menomonee Falls High School who is a student at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee. Jessica teaches baton for the recreation department. And Amanda Sonneman of Sussex is the color guard captain. She's a graduate of Sussex Hamilton High School, who is a student at Alverno College.
The Irish Theme Corps has won 39 United States championships, 24 world titles, and 54 Wisconsin state championships. It appeared in the movie The Fugitive, starring Tommy Lee Jones and Harrison Ford. The Corps has marched in Dublin, Ireland for St. Patrick's Day twice.
Now following them, we have the Daily Dolls, and they're their mascots, and the ages are between 3 and 8. Keep them cool. Doing a good job out there.
Well, they're a wonderful job. This next major event for the Corps will be competing at the University of Notre Dame in July.
While we have a minute here, we'd like to go through some of the great sponsors that we have for this parade. It would be the Cornerstone Bank and the All-American Window and Door Company, Community Memorial Hospital and Hallmark, the Hallmark store.
We have the Greater Menomonee Falls Foundation, which is an organization here in Menomonee Falls that gives grants to nonprofit organizations, and they work with donors within the community.
I can hear the banjo band now. It's the Milwaukee Banjo Band. They were formed in 1939, and they say that they have had several leaders that have passed on, but there's always someone to keep up the tradition.
In a good old summertime. When asked to describe what kind of music they play, their answer was rip snorting, foot stomping, great super dancing music wherever you may be.
Here we have the Falls.
Menomonee Falls baseball team. Falls baseball team plays its schedule during the summer. They're getting close to the end of their season. And as of last week, they were ranked number one in the area of all of the baseball teams. They compete in the very tough Metro Conference. And of the teams, the 14 teams in the Metro Conference, seven are in the top 10 in the area. And following them is the Junior Indians boys. Again, we had a group earlier carrying the banner. And again, this is an organized baseball league for highly skilled athletes. And many of them will go on and play high school baseball.
Some more of our sponsors are Cousins, the Century Food Store, Blair's True Value, Nordstrom Jewelers, North Hills,
D&S Food Service, DeMarini's, Family Pet Clinic, Friends of Nature 2, Frederick Health, which is Community Memorial Hospital and Frederick Health Medical Group.
Also BMO Harris.
Yes. Menomonee Falls Rotary Club is also a wonderful organization in the community that supports this, as well as Malkin's Carpets, the Knights of Columbus, and the Greater Menomonee Falls Foundation, who just drove by. I would like one of those spray bottles, Linda,
yeah,
that we just saw.
Next we have Falls Patio Players. And they were formed at a meeting on the patio outside the pool at North Middle School. They've been going since 1966, and they've been doing four shows a season at North Auditorium. They're known for their Christmas carol, as well as being liked and boosts a cast of 60 or more of all ages.
And they're celebrating their 47th season this year. Many of the costumes and most of the sets are built by the crew members and their seamstresses. For the spring musical, they're hoping to perform Beauty and the Beast. Our Optimist Club has been very fortunate to have very active members from the patio players.
This is the Flying Electrons Radio Control Aviation Club of Menomonee Falls.
Formed in 1960.
They have an annual charity benefiting Menomonee Falls Boy Scout Troop 110, and that will be on August 4th. It's a Saturday this year, a rain date of August 5th.
I believe we have the Center Stage Dance Teams next. Palm and Dance Group, formed in 2003.
Julie Fullerton started the group to give girls experience and develop performance skills and confidence.
One of the themes that this dance really helps kids with, the young girls with, is how to participate in a team environment. They'll be performing at the Sussex Lions Days Parade and the Richfield Days Parade.
They also will be performing at Summerfest and State Fair. Here we have Tizino's Pizza. on the corner of Pilgrim and Silver Spring.
Pilgrim and Silver Spring. Unique pizza experience there. It's a buffet pizza experience. And the food is very good, I can tell you that from experience. There are two Tizzinos in the area. One is down in Oak Creek. In fact, the owner of Tizzinos lives in Oak Creek. And if I remembered his name, I'd let you know.
Other sponsors of ours are Hanson Softwater, Kettle Hills Golf Club, Knights of Columbus, number 4240, Krieger's Entertainment Center, Lou Teets, who is a longtime resident of Menomonee Falls, Majeski's Century, and Malkin's Carpet.
We have the Newman Cole Ventures, which is Shelley's hallmark, too. Coming up now is the Dynamite Dance.
And there is Lou Teets.
And there was Lou Teets.
Yeah.
He's sitting right next to us, enjoying the parade. This was opened in 2007 by sisters Christina and Teresa Urch. Competitive dance, like the Dynamite Dance Troupe and the organization that was prior to them, is a very competitive and fast-growing competitive sport, actually.
Yes.
It's a wonderful way for our young women to keep in shape and
it's
learn
skills.
It's very
demanding, yes.
Very demanding.
And earlier we had the Gerlach Stilt Walkers. My notes came up now about it, but Dan built his first pair of stilts with his dad as a Cub Scout project. And he's been doing it since then. They keep making them taller, and his younger sister has now joined them, but he's taller than Dan.
Ah, a little bit of competitive sibling pressure
right,
there.
Right, right. We have Express News coming through.
They're throwing candy at us. We're trying to read and catch candy at the same time.
This is the Glassman Drum and Bugle Corps.
Wonderful organization out of Toledo, Ohio.
It's a non-profit youth organization for men and women between the ages of 16 and 22. They rely heavily on a philosophy of involving a family approach, and they originated in 1961.
They were originally known as the Mommy Sons. The Corps performs throughout Northwest Ohio at parade corps until it entered the Ohio American Legion competition and was renamed the Glass City Optimists,
mm-hmm.
which I like.
Yes. We'll let you enjoy them.
I was driving down to the airport this morning at 6:30 in the morning, and I saw their buses pull into town. Glassmen have long had a tradition of excellence within the drum and bugle corps activities and have established themselves as a performing group that dares to explore new horizons and offer exciting world-class performances for their fans.
The Glassmen also serve as the principal ensemble for their entertainment clinic series, which are hands-on educational workshops and events.
The lessons and life skills they take with them continue to serve them into their adult lives. For over 50 years, the Glassmen Drum and Bugle Corps has provided an experience of a lifetime for these young men and women. One of our sponsors.
We have a longtime sponsor and participant in the parade. It's the All-American Window and Door Company.
Ben and Terry Lodwick are the owners of All-American Window and Door. And I've had the opportunity to know both Ben and Terry for about 40 years. He doesn't look that old, but he is. I had the opportunity to meet Ben on the day that he started his business.
Really?
I did. He was my tenant back in 1972.
Don, you've been here a long time.
A long time.
We do have the Falls Area Food Pantry coming up. It's in Menomonee Falls, and the food pantry was originally formed as a Falls Area Christian Task Force, which was FACT up to 2009, when it was changed to the Falls Area Community Services, which is FACS. It's a nonprofit organization, and the FACS, FACS, has been around since 2009 with its new board and organizational structure.
And a new building over
and
near the community
building.
Center off
Trinary
of Menomonee River Parkway.
And
yes.
In the middle of that. Packed 60 of our Cub Scouts going past. And the Lebanon Band coming down the road. This was formed by German immigrants with a love of music, and they settled in the Lebanon area. They merged two church bands into one band and called it the Lebanon Band in 1890.
The Lebanon Band, known as the largest band from the smallest community in the state of Wisconsin. It was selected to receive the prestigious 2010 Saddle Historical Community Band Award.
They're going to be in the German Fest Parade, the Watertown 4th of July Parade, and the Dodge County Firemen's Parade.
When we asked them, I'm sorry, Linda, go ahead.
Oh, and we're awfully glad they're here.
We are. When we asked them about their music, they said they like to play the Bud song, which we just heard. We have our cheerleaders.
Well, now this, I believe, is the Menomonee Falls Captains and Leaders Float.
That's correct.
And it is captains from athletic teams and leaders from co-curricular activities. And each team has its own set of captains chosen by coaches and or the press. And peers, I'm sorry.
And peers, yes. Peers. And they change each year, of course.
Yes.
The Milk Blake Award, some of the participants in this have won the Milk Blake Award. And the Milt Blake Award is a scholarship given to the top male and female athlete of each senior class. They are selected by the coaching staff.
This year's winners were Jenna Woodson. She's a GMC Soccer Player of the Year, and basketball player Brennan Schneider, a football, basketball, and baseball player. Jenna will be attending Whitewater this fall, and Brennan will be attending St. Norbert's.
We have driving this vehicle the new athletic director, Ryan Anderson. And it said his son, Nolan, but I don't believe that's his son, although I think Nolan might be in the back.
And here we...
Actually, Linda, it's turning out to be a lovely evening.
It is.
It's
really comfortable now. And there we have Dave Petroff, who is our retiring athletic director, also an Optimist Club member. And there is Jenna Woodson.
And Brennan Schneider. Oh, I wonder if Brennan's driving the car.
Oh, he could be.
Could be. Milwaukee.
I hear the Dancing Grannies. They were formed in 1984 as an exercise group, and this award-winning group of grannies perform in about 20 parades each year from Memorial Day to Christmas. They've won many trophies, but it's enthusiasm and smiles from children and adults of all ages that warm the hearts of the Milwaukee Dancing Grannies.
I love the Grammys. They're good because they practice once a week, year-round. They strive for their best performance each time. The only requirement for membership is to be a grandmother. Their ages range from early 50s to mid-70s. Rumor has it they have approximately 100 grandchildren and a few great-grandchildren.
And we have the Menomonee Falls High School cheerleading group, varsity and junior varsity. Cheerleaders cheer at football games and at boys and girls basketball games. The cheerleaders also compete at local competitions, and the varsity team attended the National High School Cheerleading Championship in Orlando, Florida in February. And at that competition, they ranked 19 out of 40. Their coach, Ashley Ortlieb, is the varsity coach, and Sharon Hank is the junior JV.
Lutheran Vanguard of Wisconsin is our next group. They are organized in 1978 to provide a musical and marching experience for the students of three Lutheran high schools located in eastern Wisconsin. The first band had a band of 95 students. In 34 seasons since that time, they've had 70 to 90 members.
Some of their parade appearances this year will be in Brilliant, Appleton, Chilton, and Sun Prairie, and of course our Menomonee Falls Parade.
They'll also be in field competitions throughout southeastern Wisconsin, including Fort Atkinson, Milwaukee, Oregon, Janesville, Mequonago, Greenfield, Sun Prairie, and Racine.
Linda, they're busy.
They are busy, Linda. Oh, there we are, Linda. Hi.
Hi.
There must be a large break here of some sort.
I think so.
We could probably finish up with some of our sponsors.
Yes.
Newman. Oh, we did the Newman Coal Ventures, but Shelley wouldn't mind if we said that again.
No, I'm sure not.
No. North Hills Country Club, R&R Insurance, Ray and Marion Etzel, wonderful local people here. Roscoff Service and Towing. Schmidt Bartelt, I believe that's a funeral home, isn't
it? Yes, it is.
It is. No, it's Schmidt Bartelt Funeral
Home. I know it well.
Value Care Pharmacy, Village of Menomonee Falls, and the William Nordstrom Jewelers.
Here we have High Point Dentistry. It's an office at Silver Spring Drive, and it's been there, I believe, there for 28 years. Dr. Jelasic has received many recognition awards through the dental community. He's former president of Greater Milwaukee Dental Association, former chairman for Wisconsin Dental Association, and Ethics Committee. And he belongs to the Chamber of Commerce.
And they just gave us two waters.
Good,
we're very
good.
Happy.
Thank you. We have the Watertown Blues Review. Which I don't believe I have any information on.
I can't.
We'll just enjoy them. There's a little fairy walking down.
It's another dance team, Linda.
Yes.
You can enjoy them.
Little ones. Oh, they're so cute.
But as you can see by the amount of these groups in our parade, it is a very, very popular activity. Organizations such as these will start the girls about 3 years old or maybe even younger, and they'll go through many different kinds of dance, learning ballet, tap, jazz, modern dance, and many of them will also incorporate tumbling.
Here we have the Kettle Moraine Model T Car Club. They are in tip-top shape. And quiet, except for their horn.
Except for the horns. I
yes.
like the horns.
I do too. There's Carl Trapp and J.J. Sellen.
Model T clubs and antique cars.
Antique cars. Here's a 1957 Chevy.
Are just so much fun, and you'll see them all summer. I know that there are many events throughout southeastern Wisconsin. In fact, last week I drove by one just on Silver Spring in Menomonee Falls, and there was about 200 different old automobiles.
Nineteen 1963 Ford convertible. Oh, Don, I remember that one.
Do you?
Yes, I do. 1966 Mustang.
Linda, I believe I'm older than all of those automobiles. Can I get an antique
you look pretty
custom
good.
License plate for myself? '68 Mustang is just absolutely gorgeous.
We have the Mississippi Mudcats here, and it's a Milwaukee jazz band going back to the late 80s. They were formed for the old beer barons, and they have patriotic music for holiday parades played in a Dixie jazz form. It's a grand old flag, Yankee Doodle Dandy, and America, and many more.
And the group is right here in Menomonee Falls.
We have they're in the Bertrand Fire Department.
Bertrand Township Fire Department.
Township. Oh, Erica Spielberg, Waukesha County Fairest of the Fair is next.
We don't have any script for Erica, but I know that she will be at the Waukesha County Fair when it's held later on this summer. It says right here that it's from July 18th to the 22nd.
I hear the Big Top Brass is a professional band that plays exciting patriotic airs and military marches, as well as spirited circus and lively turn-of-the-century ragtime pieces. They play the music of America. The band is attired in, well, they're very easygoing.
Yeah, but it's black trousers and red shirts, and they'll have red, white, and blue caps on today.
Right. Last July, the band won first place in the East Troy, Hales Corners, and New Berlin 4th of July celebrations. In the October and November, the band performed at Mitchell Field for the Stars and Stripes homecoming flight, honoring our World War II veterans.
They're also going to perform in Arizona in December and February, and they recorded a couple of CDs.
John McCure from WTMJ, and Eric Bilstadt.
And John's an Optimist Club member here in Menomonee Falls.
He's on at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And we have the Lone Ranger.
Ron Jaguar is the Lone Ranger here in Wisconsin, dressed in an authentic costume. He's Wisconsin's Lone Ranger, and he has a costume that's about as authentic as you can get. His hat and gun belt were made by the same company that crafted the original hat and belt for Clayton Moore.
He started in 2005.
He did.
Mm-hmm. He's been doing it for quite a while. And we have the Statue of Liberty. She has walked in our parade for 25 years. And this is a gal, Debbie Davis, who is a history teacher and a community organizer. We have Peace Yoga Studio, and it opened on Appleton Avenue in the Brady Realty Company building in September of 2011. That's coming up, or it just was, just before her. It is headed by Diane, and she was involved in fitness. I have to give her a personal recommendation. She is a wonderful teacher.
Porter's Borders. Menomonee Falls Neighborhood Watch is next event. The group was formed in 1986 by the Crime Prevention Task Force, and it was commissioned by then-Village President Bob Stoliga and the Village Board. It was formed by launching a neighborhood block watch group. The block watch captains organized elected officers and drafted bylaws. In 2009, the group was awarded the best watch in the country by the National Sheriff's Association.
Now we have the Menomonee Falls Varsity Dance Team and Kids Clinic participants. The dance team has been at the high school for 30 years, but just recently added the Kids Clinic in June that gives all the participants an opportunity to dance in the parade. The team held tryouts in May for the 2012-2013 school year. The team has successfully competed at local, state, and national competitions.
This team will perform at all of the home varsity football games this fall, as well as several competitions beginning in November. They love upbeat music and upbeat songs.
Next, we have the Friends of Nick Oliver, and it's organized to run for the State Assembly for the 22nd District. This year is his first year running.
Next is probably one of the most fun events in the entire parade, and that is the Muskego Lions motorized boats. I hope they have a lot of water in there, Linda.
Oh, yeah.
They've been motorized boats performed by Lion members to have fun and raise money for the Lion charities. The parade units consists of anywhere from 7 to 10 original boats modified for parade use. Many awards for most entertaining parade unit.
All the funds generated by this parade unit are donated to charity. Those children are getting wet. I bet they feel really good now.
I think they love it.
Oh,
let's not look
yes.
their way. Maybe they'll ignore
oh.
us.
We have young Rembrandts here. It's a Menomonee Falls group that's coordinated by Don Eisenhower. It's a new business encouraging youngsters who love to draw or paint. If interested, contact Don at eisenhaurs@youngrembrandts.com. Whoa, quite a horse. And we have Brader. There's Don.
Here's Don.
We have the Bourbon Street Stompers, which we don't have any material on.
They must be a late entry into the parade.
The programs that the Optimist Club sponsors are the Independence Day Parade today, Adopt a Highway, Children's Magic Show, Chili Dinner, Essay Contest, Fall Cleanup for Senior Citizens, Junior Miss or Distinguished Young Woman Scholarship Program, Oratorical Contest.
They all run the Packers Scholarship Raffle each year. It's one of the fundraisers that will help us give scholarships to deserving seniors. Again, our popcorn wagon. I mentioned post-prom earlier today. One of the best programs we run is Respect for Law, when we will give awards to people who have done the right thing throughout the community.
I think this is the water truck. They're
yes.
giving out bottles of water.
It's a good thing to have today. There looks like there's several of them.
That is a good idea.
I would really like to know who sponsors them. It looks like MataraVest.com.
Metro Harvest Church.
That's what it is. It's the okay. Metro Harvest Church is launched in the 90s, and they first met at North Junior High. They've been around for 22 years. They've received awards from the school district of Menomonee Falls for donations of backpacks and school supplies. And as you saw, they helped today by just donating water.
And they're planning that backpack and school supply day on Sunday, August 19th.
Justin Zolich, Fox News 6 meteorologist. And there's a whole lot of people are going to be asking for cooler weather and maybe some rain.
Not too many clouds. I don't think we're going to get it right now anyway. That's good because we're having a parade. Almost Live Entertainment. It was founded by Diane in 1991, and they started singing together. Entertaining singing. Elvis and the Rat Pack, doo-wop, country rock and roll, and they do weddings, parties, retirement centers, anything. They also do a DJ and karaoke.
Well, that I'm not surprised.
Go Elvis. Thank you. Oh,
I'm lucky so, you, Linda.
Yes, I'm so special.
Menomonee Falls.
The Menomonee Falls Angels.
Community band. John Woger is the director.
The community band is made up by adults and student musicians from Menomonee Falls and surrounding areas. 10 years ago, they were formed by the Community Recreation Department.
Upcoming events for this group will be the Village Concert in the Park.
This is Old Falls Village. Civil War Encampment, July 21st and 22nd.
The group has been around since the 60s, and they have the Civil War Encampment in July.
Yes.
They also do something for Halloween, and they have a Christmas tea.
Some of the donations that the Optimist Club gives is the Menomonee Falls Junior Indians Baseball, the Menomonee Falls Library, Menomonee Falls Parades, Scholarships, Students of the Month, Menomonee Falls Teen Court, Veterans Day, Village Center Concerts, the YMCA, PAC 109 Cub Scouts, and the Girl Scout Camp Sponsorship.
They'll also donate each year to the Miller Davidson House. This is Grace Lutheran. Grace Evangelical Lutheran Church has just built a new church on Crossway View, just south of County Line Road. The school is still on Kenworth. Church began in 1932 by two couples who wanted a Lutheran church in Menomonee Falls.
And that was a Christian, contemporary Christian live praise band. The Avon Shop, a store in Menomonee Falls right here in this shopping center, I believe, that we're right across from.
It opened in November of 2009. One of the largest groups we have each year is the Falls Baptist Church, and this year their event is Falls Kingdom. The church was started by Evangelist David Barba. Since 1974, the Falls Baptist Church has been part of the Menomonee Falls community. In December 2010, the Falls Baptist Chamber Strings performed at the Midwest Clinic in Chicago.
The Falls Baptist Church includes numerous ministries, including Reformers Anonymous, Addiction Program, Falls Baptist Academy, and the Baptist College of Ministry, as well as an extensive music training program. Vacation Bible School, I saw, was in July. It's July 16th through the 20th.
That's right.
It's actually, it includes moms, dads, grandmas, and grandpas.
Cool. I love each year how creative
wow,
they get with their flow.
This is unbelievable this year.
Let's hope that the people on that float have an opportunity to get some water.
Wow. And here we have the dragon following behind, close behind.
It is
the
a
castle
great costume.
And the dragon. Yes. Unbelievable. I think they've outdone themselves.
Each year I wonder what they're going to come back with. It's so much fun to watch. Again, this is a Falls Baptist Church.
This is Sandy's Family Hair Design, and she's been in business for 30 years. And their excellence in hair design for the 30 years, they make wigs sold to cancer and chemotherapy patients, recognized by all hospitals in the Milwaukee area. They are in the Christmas Parade, the Christmas Walk, and the Village Trick-or-Treat.
Karate America Menomonee Falls. It's been in Wisconsin for 34 years. And Karate America is located on Appleton Avenue near Main Street.
It was started by Randy Reed. He owned and operated, it is owned and operated by brothers Mark Quirk and Jeff Quirk. And they teach Leadership and Life Skills Academy. Builds kids' confidence, focus, respect, and discipline in a fun and healthy environment. This is the Legacy Christian Church of Menomonee Falls. It's a group of non-denominational churches that got together and decided to work together to start a new church. The Legacy officially began holding workshop services at Menomonee Falls High School in October of 2011, just recently.
Legacy has been recognized for community service by the school district, Falls administrators, the food pantry, the House of Love Youth Homes, and the Old Falls Village.
And as a church, their mission is to help people find and follow God. It is the goal to be a community of faith that is not self-centered, but rather seeks to build a legacy beyond themselves.
Their music group sings contemporary music and classic hits. And this one's one of my favorite classics. I'll try not to sing.
Okay.
following Legacy Christian Church will be State Representative Don Pridemore. Representative Pridemore has been serving in the Wisconsin State Legislature since 2004. He's currently representative for the 22nd District, including Menomonee Falls, Sussex, Erin, Lisbon, and Butler. How do you like his slogan?
His slogan is good.
I like it. More pride, less tax.
This is Thomas Orthodontics, and it's Jess T. Thomas. It's on Menomonee Avenue.
Another late entry into this parade. The parade keeps growing each year.
We have about 90 units usually.
Well, I've actually lost track. Other organizations that the Optimist Club donates to is the Miller Davidson House, Menomonee Falls Athletic Facilities, the Menomonee Falls Jazz Ensemble, Menomonee Falls Safety Fair, Leadership Menomonee Falls, Bowl-a-thon, and the High School Band. What do we have here, Linda?
I'm not sure what it is. Tigers? Lions and Tigers and Bears?
Oh, my. I know. I had to do it.
This is the Zion Lutheran Church. And that is on the corner of Lisbon Road and Brookfield Road. It was founded as a daughter congregation of the Emmanuel Lutheran Church. And Zion was founded in 1883. Enrollment is 192 students. They moved to Menomonee Falls in December of 1969. The Lutheran School is nationally accredited and offers academic, art, sports, and a Bible-shared religious training. Zion's mission is to share Jesus Christ's message of salvation and forgiveness of sins for all those who believe and trust
in him.
I'm sorry,
Linda, I thought you were done. This Eric Hovde, one of our U.S. Senate runners, Eric Hovde, again, is one of a number of people running on the Republican ticket for U.S. Senate November.
I'm sorry, Don. This is the Lush Suites and Salon. It's a full-service beauty salon located near Pop's Custard on the corner of Appleton and Jacobson Drive. It's locally owned and operated by a mother and daughter's team, stylists Ashley, Molly, and Jackie. The salon opened in January 2012.
Are we wrapping it up now? Are we off camera?
Here's the Lush Studio.
Joe Cool Racing.
This is one of the units I really wanted to see. It sounds very, very interesting.
Well, they began racing. It's a family that started racing while they were young, and they moved up as the years gone on. They're currently racing late models, and they keep striving to grow. They've won many awards and trophies, and they've been at this since for 17 years. They are weekly racers at the Slinger Speedway on Sunday nights. Oh, you can't miss that, can you?
Whoa. With one of the cars
oh,
on the back. And we have the South Shore drill team coming up here.
I feel so close to you right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love falls down on me.
In 1980, Chicago Public Schools teacher Arthur Robertson founded the South Shore Drill Team to offer a positive and creative outlet for inner city youth.
They've done wonderful work with these youth on the south side of Chicago, where dropout rates range from 50 to 99%, and many of their students, or most of their students, do very well.
Now they're graduating with their class, and most go on to college and technical school. Over the past three decades, an estimated 5,000 young people have been part of the group. And the proud alumni include teachers, police officers, entrepreneurs, business managers, people in the entertainment field, and medical professionals. And they also appeared on NBC Today Show in 2010. So it looks like the parade is ending here, and we would like to thank all of you for joining us. It's been a wonderful evening. Thank you, Don, for coming out.
Thank you, Linda.
Okay.
I'm glad I was able to jump in there at last minute.
Yes.
Hopefully we didn't make too many mistakes.
No, I think we're fine.
Yeah. But again, thank you very much for joining us. The Optimist Club really loves putting this on. And again, this will be an annual event. We look forward to being with you again next year.
Yes. It's a good thing. We're going to be off to the fireworks now. Hopefully we will be able to have them. But we have so many members from the Optimist Club to thank for this particular event. We wouldn't be able to do it, of course, alone.
No.
Harry Stetzel and his camera crew are wonderful to work with, and we just want to thank them a lot.
We really do. That group is very professional.
Yes.
And helped us along the way. We've had a number of people who work on this parade each year. Greg Goss was the person who ran it in 2012, along with Charlie Keller. Charlie Keller has been involved with this. Again, thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you so much for joining us this evening, and to see you again next year then, we hope. Good night.
Good night.
Yeah.